The team is divided into three subsystems: mechanical, electronics, and management. Mechanical team is responsible for making a stiff chassis on which all other components can be mounted. Develop a suspension which can overcome all difficult terrains. Design and manufacture robotic arm and end effector. Electronics team is responsible for power, programming, sensor installation, data acquisition, and communication with the rover. We tested the rover near our college at Manipal Lake, a perfect place having the right conditions for testing. We made arrangements like the task in the competition by setting up gates, made the rover overcome steep slopes and rocky terrain.
We have used a customized rocker bogie suspension where the bogie is connected to the rover and the rocker is supported by a damper. The balloon tires are used to prevent the rover from sinking in loose and sandy terrain.
To test the rocker bogie suspension, ascent of 0.5 meter was tested. A wireless range of 800 meters was achieved. Here the control through joystick gave us the freedom for sudden change in speed when the rover had to come out of difficult places, and also the ease of 360 degree movement of the rover.
The rover is also capable of descending a vertical drop of about 0.8 meters.
For the astronaut assistance task, we simulated to lift a mallet of 0.4 kg and a toolbox of 4 kg.
The robotic arm is made of two links. Each link is an integration of two aluminium water jet cut sheets.
We have used two electrical linear actuators for movement of the arm. The arm can go up to vertical height of 1 meter from ground. The end effector works on a screw jack mechanism which is capable of lifting objects of up to 5 kg. The pitch and roll motion of the end effector is provided by differential gear mechanism. The main camera is rigidly mounted at a specific height by a tube for a better view for driving the rover, whereas the bullet camera is mounted to give a closer view of the objects while performing the task.
Stepper motor has been used for rotation of full robotic arm. The rover is also capable of keeping small objects on itself to finish the tasks faster.
The PCB was designed in-house and was custom manufactured, keeping in mind the sensitivity of the control signals for undescripted communication in the system. The rover is powered with a 224V 10,000 mAh LiPo battery, which are then modulated and stepped down via DC to DC converters. Due to the high current capacity of the battery, fuse box has been used to ensure safety of the components. For proficient control of the rover, high performance motor drivers have been used for the main motors and a lesser rating ones for the actuator and the other motors in the arm. We have used intra-rover communication between Raspberry Pi, Atmega and Arduino. Raspberry Pi acts as the nucleus which exchanges data with the other two. Raspberry Pi receives the control signal which it processes and transmits to Atmega and Arduino for rover control. The Arduino is used for servo control and acquisition of data from the sensors. All the data is processed in the Raspberry Pi and then distributed. We have used two frequency bands for communication. 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. 2.4 GHz is used for transmitting and receiving control signals, and the 5 GHz band is used for live video feed from the cameras. 5 GHz was used to ensure there is sufficient bandwidth for clear video feed. Servicing task, the rover started a bench grinding machine by turning its knob. As per rule book, we have to open a valve by turning it, and we also have to pour fuel. So we simulated this condition on a water bottle. The end effector by its roll motion opened the cap of the bottle. Holding the bottle, the rover goes to another location and pours the water in a jar. The scoop for science cache task is 3D printed. Temperature and humidity sensor is mounted inside the scoop. The same arm can reach 10 cm inside the ground with the scoop attached to it. The differential mechanism motor provides high torque for easy penetration of scoop inside the soil.
Our science plan is divided into on rover and at the base station. At the base station, we have further categorized them into three main domains, namely geological, biological, and chemical. On rover, the rover will house sensors to measure the basic attributes of soil, which are the temperature, moisture, and pH. Once the soil sample is received, tests will be done under the three main domains at the base station. Geological, the soil sample will be segregated depending on the grain sizes, and then tests will be performed to determine the color and permeability of the soil. Biological. Tests will be performed for protein detection, nucleic acid detection, and gram staining will be performed. Chemical. The concentration of soil organic carbon and nitrates and nitrites will be determined. Based on the results obtained in each category, we will be able to establish a link between the three domains, which together help us conclude about the sample quality for determining the possibility or existence of life.
Financial summary. The estimated cost of the project is $10,000. This cost includes the funds which were used in developing, testing, and the losses incurred during the developing phase. Explicit cost of the developed model would be $7,000. Coming to the sponsorship part, this year has been good for us as we have received sponsorship from 5 corporates and an event sponsor. We are really thankful to Wheelies for giving us tires, Pranit Engineering Works for doing manufacturing for us, Taxis for giving us 3D printed products, Mahalakshmi Buildwells for their funds, MG Super Labs for providing us electronic equipment, and Protagase for manufacturing products for us.